One of the approaches to unify the production and development environments is called a golden image. The idea is to take the operating system, libraries, and our application itself, and wrap them up in a standard or golden master image of a virtual machine that can be used and reused without the need to configure each new machine individually. These golden images can be used both on desktop workstations as a virtual machine and on servers. You can also create golden images of containers. Another approach is to just install a base operating system and then use a configuration management system that performs automatic installation and configuration of software on every machine under its control, thus making sure that all the machines have the same configuration. To be sure of that, the installation should start from the same base OS image, otherwise there could be OS level differences. The difference is that a golden image system requires more work up front and has to be regenerated whenever there are any changes. But once it's done, it's very fast to boot up a new server or VM with it. With a configuration management system, on the other hand, booting up will be slower because every machine needs to install the same software on the first boot. However, if there is a configuration change, it's easy and fast to get these changes out to the machines without the need to regenerate the image. And of course, you can have something in between. For instance, install the base software and libraries, perform the main configuration, create a golden image, and then use it to bring up the machines. Then once they're up, use a configuration management system to perform smaller rolling updates. If both the image creation and configuration management processes are automated and in a version control system, it's easy to reproduce these steps. And that's what you'll do as the first step in this project. Build a golden image that has all the software necessary for dev and also works in the cloud for a production server. You won't work with a configuration management system in this project because that topic would require a whole course of its own. Maybe later. For now, you will have to download and install a couple of programs. Press next to see the instructions.